Hello, my name is Matthias Bolm.
And I'm Tom Eicher.
And we are Technical Solution Manager at Osram. And today, we are showing you the new DALI Pro 2 IoT. Now, we want to map our devices. And for this, we need to start the device search. Before we start the device search, all devices need to be connected to our two DALI channels, A and B. During the search process, all devices connected to the DALI 1 and DALI 2 channel are checked. If not all devices are available, you should check your installation and start the search process again. All devices are showing a DALI short address. The A stands for the DALI line A and the B for the DALI line B. The number behind that is a randomly used number for the DALI addresses between 1 and 64. If the list of devices is complete, you can close this list. Now, to identify all our luminaires in our project, we are starting the blinking chain. Now we have identified our training room luminaire, which has the number B4. And now we take our luminaire B4 via drag and drop into our room. Now our luminaire B4 is directly mapped to our room 1 and it is vanished out of our general device list. Now we want to identify the sensor for our room. For this, we need to start the reverse mode. This will be the sensor for our room. By demonstrating movement, the sensor will be activated and it will be marked in our device list. Now we have identified the right sensor and we can drag and drop it into our room. As we have a combined sensor with light, we just drag and drop the light sensor into our room as well. As we want to have additionally a push button in our room, we need to identify this one as well. As the reverse mode is still activated, we are just clicking the push button and the push button identifies itself. Via drag and drop, we take the push button into our room. Now we have finalized our complete room setup with one luminaire, one combination sensor with movement and light sensor, and one push button. The devices in our room 1 will get the name of the room, and our sensor S3 will get an additional M for the movement sensor and an additional L for the light sensor. We can easily rename every device. And we can also easily unmap every single device out of our room. Before we can finish our setup, we need to calibrate our sensor. During the calibration process, the light will be switched off, so the sensor can just measure the daylight, and the light will be switched on, that the sensor can measure the daylight plus the artificial light, and the difference will be our calibration result. For a successful daylight calibration, make sure that you are not calibrating when it's completely dark or with full daylight. If we want to change our room settings, we need to click on the eye symbol and then on properties to change the respective settings. If the brightness in the room is too high, we just need to bring down the regulation value. For our motion sensor, we need to select now the action of the sensor. Do we want to start with our motion detection, the light regulation? Or do we say go to level and we set up the respective level? The same we will now define for our push button. Here we can choose between the actions for short push and long push. Now we have finished all the settings of our room 1, and now we will go to our multi-desk office. And here we will do exactly the same as we have done for our room 1 already, by drag and drop creating our areas with our luminaires and our sensors. Now we have finished our complete setup, and at the end we need to synchronize, and during the synchronization process all the software settings will be transferred into the control unit. After the successful synchronization, our system is ready and can be used.